So what I'll do today is we'll start at the circulation. And what we're looking for is whether you can discern the difference between the filament on your foot or bending. Can you feel it bend?
I feel that.
Just swing over to the side of the chair and I'm going to look for your reflex. What we're looking for when we remove the nail polish is changes in color to the nail, any evidence of fungus beneath the nail itself, mm-hmm. any dark discolorations within the nail bed, black and blue areas underneath the nail, or what we call hematomas, any things that could be risk factors.
Now, is it ever dangerous to wear nail polish if you have a foot fungus or something?
Using nail polish occludes or keeps the moisture inside the nail, and that increases the chance the nails is going to develop a fungus. What I'd like to do is just take a look underneath the nails and to the nails themselves and inspect them for any debris that may accumulate underneath the nail, mm-hmm. such as fungus or any other foreign object that hairs, animal hairs and things like that may be in the house. And they look relatively in good condition here. Now work our way back, and what we're looking for now is just inspecting between the toes. Very important thing just to do at home. So inspection. Next thing we're looking for are pressure points underneath the bottom of your foot. And these areas can be then come high risk for just a blister to form.
Okay.
Good. Now just walk forward right off the mat. Terrific. At the greatest amount of pressure in the forward part of your foot is where we're seeing the callusing, which is up in the front. And then there's a tremendous amount of pressure on those hammer toes. So this just shows us where we want to build an orthotic or an insert for your shoes for athletics or for your daily wear that's going to offload some of the pressure that may be of highest risk for you developing an ulcer or some type of complication.
I'm here with the leading podiatrist, Dr. Andrew Rice. Thank you, Dr. Rice. Did you bring me presents?
I do. I have a present for you. In fact, in the office, if you remember, we sketched out those areas of highest pressure. And then what we did is we made a custom diabetic orthotic for you to cushion those hammer toes, to cushion the area with the callus forms, which are high-risk areas for blisters and other ulcers and things. And then we customized the arch for you. So let's try those.
I'm game.
So we're going to take out your insert, which comes with this sneaker, and we'll press these in. Why don't you try those on?
Okay. I don't need to put socks on or anything?
Well, we have a pair of socks for you. These are nice breathable socks. They allow exchange of moisture.
Nice breathable socks. Whoa, that feels good. Oh, that feels good already. Oh, hey! Oh, wow. And I'm telling you, I am not a tennis shoe wearing person, but this is, oh my goodness.
Now you feel good support. No crowding. No crowding in that
chair. No, not at all.
Wonderful.
And I can walk in these and jog.
For about an hour, and then I want you to take the shoe off and look for any areas of irritation.
Okay. These feel good, so this is going to help my hammer toes.
Yes, cushion them.
Okay. What is that?
In those cases where we need a shoe that has enough height for very bad hammer toes, which you do not have, but for very bad hammer toes, we look for the height of the shoe, and a flat sole, something that's going to grip but not catch on its carpet.
So now this is a custom shoe as well?
That's actually a custom shoe, that's correct, and that's made from a custom mold. And again, offloading pressure. Take the pressure away, okay?
Now you got the little foot thing.
What I wanted to use this for was just to show you, these are all the pressure points, toes, metatarsals, heel, and then sometimes with a flat foot, we have them in the mid-arch area. So we want to protect those areas and inspect.
Okay, so now what are all these things?
We use foot care products quite often as far as recommendations go. Mm-hmm. We like creams that are applied to the sole of the foot, take care of the cracks that develop on the foot. Mm-hmm. We want to make sure those cracks don't become infected. They become areas of risk.
Okay.
And particularly when we have insensitive feet or lack of circulation, the small vessel disease and things.
Now, you have a toenail clip here. I've been told as a person with diabetes, don't cut my toenails. Go to my podiatrist and let my podiatrist cut my toenails. So I let you cut my toenail.
And I have to tell you, I tell my patients that as well.
Okay.
But that's self-serving. So I know they're going to do it on their own.
Okay.
So what I want to tell them is you want to find a clipper that's straight across, if you can find one. You want to find one that you're only going to trim your nail straight across. And albeit we know that the nail doesn't grow straight across. We know it grows into the sides. Leave those alone. Go to your podiatrist, your foot care specialist, and have those taken care of. What you shouldn't use are the things for plasters, for corns. Those are acids. And I brought these only just to show you not to use the acid solutions.
Oh.
You know, you wouldn't touch a car battery without gloves on.
Right.
Okay. But why would you put an acid on your feet, particularly if you're insensitive?
That.
Absolutely.
Okay, don't put that on your foot. Now, the socks. Now, that's a sock. Okay.
I brought socks really just to show you the fleece material. Okay. Fleece does come in a white material as well. But the fleece exchanges moisture and also provides insulation. An excellent product. We used to say never synthetic. Uh-huh. But now we have synthetic products that do a beautiful job to insulate, exchange moisture very well, and you need to change those at least twice a day, okay? And never barefooted at home.
So now what general advice would you give to people about their feet and how to care for their feet?
Well, recommended again, inspection. Most important thing is inspect and look at your feet, look between the toes, look to the nails, look for the hardened areas of skin. Apply the moisturizing cream if you have dry feet. Don't over-moisturize if you don't. And really be vigilant about your blood sugar, because blood sugar directly affects the lack of sensation.
Absolutely. That's how my sister lost her leg, and it is so important to take care of your feet. Dr. Rice, I want to thank you so much. Thank you for my feet and a close-up personal view. And thank you for sharing such great information with us.